We're going to look at deriving the sine, cosine, and tangent for 30 degrees and 60 degrees. So we're going to start with looking at a triangle. And let's just assume that this triangle has 60 degree angles in it. Remember that a triangle, their angles add up to 180. So this would have 360 degree angles in it. So if the angles are the same, the sides have to be the same. So we're just going to pick a number, and I'm going to make it 2. Now, if I split this angle in half and I draw straight down perpendicular, this would make this 90 degrees, and this would make this one 30 degrees because it's in half. So now we have a 30-60 degree triangle. And we know that this side is a 2. This side is a 1 because we split it in half. We drew our line down. And if this whole thing is 2, that means this is 1 and this is 1. So we could use our Pythagorean theorem. And we could use c squared equals a squared plus b squared. And this is c, so c squared is 4. Legs, 1 squared. And we don't know this other leg. So 4 minus 1 is 3, so b squared is 3, which means that that side is square root of 3. So now that we actually have a labeled triangle with all the sides labeled, we can find sine, cosine, and tangent of 30 degrees because we know all the parts of the triangle. So sine of 30, here's the 30 degree angle, side opposite over hypotenuse would be 1/2. Cosine of 30 would be side adjacent over hypotenuse, so square root of 3 over 2. And then tangent of 30 is side opposite over adjacent, so 1 over square root of 3. And most books are not going to leave you with the radical in the denominator, so we're going to rationalize by multiplying both the top and the bottom by square root of 3. So this would be square root of 3 over 3. So you can check it real quick on your calculator. If I change my calculator to degrees and I hit sine of 30, I do indeed get, let's see, sine of 30, I do indeed get 0.5. Cosine of 30, I do indeed get 0.8660. And if I check that, the square root of 3 over 2 is 0.8660. And if I hit tangent of 30, I get 0.5774. And if I hit square root of 3 divided by 3, that is 0.5774. So it all checks out.